We begin with the latest on the COVID-19 situation in Cebu City. Its acting mayor appealing for more health workers to help fend off the rising number of cases there. Acting Mayor Michael Rama says at least 3 hospitals in the city are now full. On Monday, videos and photos circulated on social media showing patients lined up outside an emergency room waiting to get admitted. Mayor Rama says the local government will open field hospitals in the coming days to ease the load at medical facilities there.
We will be doing it sa aming malaking sports complex that will be bringing, the asymptomatic, yung mild, and may perhaps moderate, para yung mga hospital natin will reduce yung pagka-overwhelm. Nanawawagan ako as acting mayor, nanawagan ako mismo sa the whole island of Cebu. Kasi marami pa naman nurses at saka medical staff, hindi lang nagtatrabaho na.
Iloilo City goes under hard lockdown today as a preemptive measure against the COVID Delta variant. Until August 8th, Sunday, travel within Panay Island to Iloilo City will be prohibited except for select persons. Only essential businesses such as markets, groceries, and drugstores will be allowed to stay open. The new restrictions come even if the city is already under the strictest lockdown classification. Mayor Jerry Trena says while the number of COVID-19 cases in the city is decreasing, hospitals are now operating at almost full capacity.
The isolation beds and both the isolation and the ICU beds are almost 98% full capacity. Mm-hmm. And this is because it is filled up with patients coming from the provinces. Only crematorium in Panay, which is found here in Iloilo City, has decided to stop receiving COVID-positive cadavers because there's a long line that needs to be cremated.
The East Avenue Medical Center is boosting its oxygen supply in preparation for a potential surge in COVID-19 cases. The hospital's medical chief, Dr. Alfonso Nunez, says the hospital is upgrading its oxygen generation plant. EAMC will also be able to help replenish the medical oxygen supply of other hospitals.
Stockpile na kami ng mga oxygen tank. And third, naglalagay na kami ng isang secondary system, yung tinatawag na vacuum insulated evaporator. This is a separate system from the oxygen generation plant and would assure us na the supply of oxygen is coming.
So far, up to 80% of the beds at the East Avenue Medical Center are occupied, up from 50% just 2 weeks ago. The Philippines records over 8,000 new COVID-19 cases for the 4th straight day. The last time this happened was 3 months ago during the last surge. This brings the nationwide tally past 1.6 million, of which more than 62,000 remain active. The health department acknowledges infections are rising in many areas, but it insists not everyone needs to be tested for the more contagious Delta variant. The DOH also warns of an uptick in the number of COVID-related fatalities. This comes as some hospitals in the country reach full capacity, like in Cebu City and at the Northern Mindanao Medical Center in Cagayan de Oro. The country's death toll had just recently breached 28,000.
Ako po'y nananawagan sa ating pong mga hospital chiefs na sa lalong madaling panahon ay gawin ang lahat para ma-convert ang inyong mga isolation beds into intensive care unit beds. Dahil ito po ang serbisyo na talagang makapagpapagaling ng atin pong mga severe and critical COVID cases, bagkos ito po ang makakapagsalba ng mga buhay.
The country's death toll from the Delta COVID-19 variant climbs to 9. The health department says one of the latest fatalities was a local case. There are still 17 active cases out of the 216 total Delta variant infections recorded in the country.